habit of underestimating you.
My time as a human was over, but I never felt more alive.
I didn't expect you to seem so... you?
In part two, Bella wakes up a newborn and meets her child and her husband as a vampire.
Bella's made the change into a vampire without a hitch, really.
We're in the same temperature now.
You've been watching four movies where you see vampires from the outside, and now you get to experience what it's like to see the world visually as a vampire might.
Bella and Edward get a chance to be together again.
I think when he has a child with Bella, it's a very happy beginning.
Baby is Renesmee. She's this wonderful half-vampire, half-human child.
I have to report a crime.
Oh my.
When the Volturi find out about this child, they suspect that their, you know, ultimate law has been broken.
Renesmee is being accused of being a child bitten by a vampire.
She is not an immortal.
You don't create vampire children. It's punishable by death.
The Cullens know that they can't take the Volturi by themselves, so they need some backup.
My family's in danger. I need your help.
I think the Cullens' greatest asset is their ability to bring in other vampires they've met around the world.
We will stand with you.
A lot of red eyes around here.
So that's what brings about the kind of cataclysmic showdown that we see in this film.
It's a big movie. It's hard to do something that matters to so many people.
It's been building up and building up and building up. It gets a very visceral reaction out of people.
They watch the movies for the same reasons that I make the movies, because I know what it's like to love something so much.